With such a significant presence in the state of Washington, many may know that Boeing 737s are born at the Renton factory. The 777 and 767 are assembled in Everett, while the 787s are now completely assembled in South Carolina. With Renton home to a large production facility, Boeing has been producing its best-selling single-aisle aircraft at the site for decades. In fact, the 737 family is known as the most produced commercial aircraft in aviation history. However, it would not be possible without 1.1 million square feet of factory space. With the entire 737 program under intense scrutiny, Elizabeth Lund, Senior Vice President, Quality at Boeing, had the opportunity to publicly share how 737s are assembled in Renton in terms of timeline. The explanation took place in August 2024 during a two-day hearing hosted by the National Transportation Safety Board, or NTSB. Here's what we know about Boeing's 10-day process to assemble a 737. Since the 737 program began in 1967, more than 10,600 jets have been rolled out of the facility. Just as the company has focused on innovation over the years, operations within the factory itself have evolved. With more workers and advanced technology, the final assembly of a 737 MAX takes about 10 days, one day less than the 11 it took for the 737NG. However, the beginning of a 737 MAX's life takes place in Kansas. Fuselages are developed by Spirit Aerosystems in Wichita, and then they're transported by freight train to Renton. Once the fuselage arrives, Boeing will begin installing the necessary equipment and features, which is where our 10 days of assembly begin. Between days 1 and 3, basic work on the fuselage begins, and insulation, hydraulic systems, and electrical wiring are installed on the fuselages. On the exterior, assembly workers will install the dorsal fin, and if the airline requests the plane to be equipped with Wi-Fi, an antenna and protective radome will also be installed. It's not until day 4 that the fuselage begins to appear more like an aircraft. This is because the wings, including the horizontal stabilizers, are then placed on both sides. The tail and vertical stabilizer are also installed along with the landing gear on the bottom of the fuselage. And then, on day 5, assembly workers bring in the rear galleys and lavatories. The aircraft is also equipped with water tanks and waste compartments, while cable riggings are connected to the flight control systems. The aircraft's fuel tank also goes through a final pressure test during the fifth day of assembly. Once the process reaches the sixth day, Boeing introduces the aircraft to oil and power for the first time. "That is where we turn it into a live airplane," Lund explains during the NTSB hearing. This marks the beginning of necessary mechanical and electronic tests on the plane. Other elements inside the cabin are also installed, such as the sidewalls and overhead bins. The forward galleys and lavatory are also placed inside on day 6. And after a week of assembly in the factory, mechanics will begin testing the pressurization of the cabin. The aircraft's fuel tank is also inspected thoroughly and cleaned. Assembly workers will then begin tests on the plane's flight control systems and landing gear to ensure it's working properly. The interior will begin to appear more like an aircraft on day 8, as Boeing will install the carpets and passenger seats. This process may take longer as each airline has different seating layouts and capacities. For example, Alaska Airlines 737 MAX 8 accommodates 159 passengers, while United Airlines 737 MAX 8 has 166 seats. Southwest Airlines 737 MAX 8 can carry 175 passengers on board, given that the plane is a single cabin. Also on day 8, flight control tests continue, including the aircraft's hydraulic systems. A thorough quality inspection also takes place. The 737 MAX's two engines are mounted on its wings on day 9. Once installed, they are connected to the plane's electronic and hydraulic systems. As Boeing prepares to roll out the aircraft from the production facility for the first time, assembly workers will conduct final inspections. This portion occurs before the full presentation to the customer. Day 10 is reserved for any final installations that were pending or any tests or assessments that are required to be performed on the aircraft. Once it is officially rolled out, there are still several more days before it will welcome passengers on board. After leaving the production facility, the plane will perform pre-flight tests and be painted in the customer's livery before finally being delivered. Boeing has three assembly lines for the 737 MAX at the Renton factory. In her introduction of the 10-day process, Elizabeth Lund explained, "At the time of September 2023, we were running only two lines to build our 737s, the West Line and Central Line. We were using the East Line to pull airplanes in to do airplane rework, but not in the baseline build of the aircraft." Last year, the Seattle Times reported that a fourth line would open this year, replacing the 787 Dreamliner assembly line that moved to Charleston. However, recent complications surrounding the company spawned by the Alaska Airlines 737 MAX 9 door blowout incident earlier this year appear to have delayed Boeing's ambitions. The FAA has been making sure that Boeing fixes its systemic production quality issues, capping 737 production in the process. Indeed, the regulator capped Boeing's production of the aircraft to 38 planes per month, which is below its projected production of 45 aircraft per month. When asked by investigators on August 7th what the production rate was prior to the accident, Lund notes that the company had approved a baseline rate of 38 aircraft per month, but was producing at a rate lower than that, stated to be upper 20s to low 30s. Lund adds that after the door plug blowout incident, Boeing is still approved to produce 38 per month. However, the company had dropped that rate considerably lower to quote-unquote single digits. Lund goes on to say that Boeing has been working its way back up to 38 per month, but says the figure, at least at the time of the hearing, was in the 20s. The cap imposed by the FAA halts Boeing from achieving its July 2025 goal of producing 57 planes per month. We previously reported that the plane maker warned its customers that delays could extend through 2026. During the hearing, Lund explained that Boeing has a so-called rate readiness process that it uses to ramp up production. This process is run by the respective airplane program and starts more than a year in advance of a rate increase. This process is supposed to make sure the aircraft program has sufficient staffing, capital equipment, tooling, and engineering resources. There's also a supply chain evaluation for increasing rate, as well as a monthly review that the FAA is invited to attend. It was also stated that Boeing began a safety risk management assessment 2 to 3 years ago for every rate increase. So, that's what we know about Boeing's 10-day process to assemble a 737 MAX. It'll be interesting to see if anything changes after FAA scrutiny and the NTSB's full investigation, not to mention Boeing's new CEO. What do you think of the process and Boeing's production rate? Let us know by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.